The kicker, Chad Ryland, has this one teed up. And we are underway from Hard Rock Stadium. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to South Florida at Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami. Today, a fun matchup in the AFC East, as it'll be the New England Patriots taking on the Miami Dolphins. Here's the punter, Jake Bailey, ready to do the honors. And we are underway from Miami. Here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Jones wants to throw to start things out here. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete. But
to deny that completion, and it came through with a nice hit and knocked it incomplete.
Now it's second and 10. There at all. He's up only to about the 16-yard line. So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 9. Now Jones. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
You get a sense of what this game plan might be. They think they can take a few home run shots against this defense. They tried it there in the opening drive, but that ball's incomplete.
So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on 4th down. And the pass to Henry is intercepted. Brandon Jones picking it off. And this one will be brought back to the 22.
Well, short of them returning it for a pick six, that was about the worst start you could ask for in this one, because your advantage of getting the ball first is gone, and they're set up a short distance from your end zone. You better be ready to come out swinging on the next series.
They'll run here with Raheem Mostert, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field, despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuck that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Now Achane on first and 10. Yeah, this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Durham Smythe, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Dolphins take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Jason Sanders now for the extra point. And that makes it 7-0 Dolphins. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
And he's missed now in his first four passing attempts. The rhythm is just not there to begin this ball game.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Throwing, Jones. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Another incompletion there. That's 5 in a row now to start this game. He's got to take a deep breath now, step back, shake it off a little bit, trust his offensive line, and hope that his play caller dials up something that can give him a completion and get him going.
Now Jones on third down, and that is incomplete.
Two drives will tell the story of this game, but you absolutely have to like how this defense has played thus far. They have yet to allow this offense to get untracked in this one.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on four. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. A surprising move to go for it predictably, at least somewhat predictably. It doesn't pay off. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line.
They're right here.
Option handoff now to Achane. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Tua going to tap this forward on the jet sweep. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. Second and goal from the one. An option pitch we saw. We didn't witness a ton of that in the NFL, but it worked there down near the goal line for a score.
And it's actually a great call in goal line situations because as as more and more quarterbacks enter the league with that mobility and having run option in college, more pro teams are adding it to their arsenal. And now it's not just, does the quarterback run it? Does he pitch it? Now they've added that third element. He can rise up and throw the ball as well.
And no return for Montgomery. Bring it out to the 25. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points category, but in the yards category. We'll see if they can do better here on this drive. They start on the ground with Elliott. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34.
At the 34-yard line.
Again, it's Elliott. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Third down and 1. To the sideline and pulled in. They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive alive.
Short yardage situation, you have to wonder if they thought that they were just going to run it inside, but you have to be cognizant of the back slipping out in the backfield trying to find some open space, and that's exactly what he does to the tune of a first down.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Elliott running right. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game, maybe establish the run? I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offense coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
Straight ahead, it's Stevenson. And it'll be a minimum pickup here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. This offense so far on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. They're able to convert with a gain of 4.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like overtime football there. 3rd and 2 is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
They keep on the ground with Elliott, and he can only manage to get a couple. 2nd and 8 coming up.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're not doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
On 2nd down, it's Stevenson. And he'll get this down close to a 1st down at about the Dolphins' 43-yard line. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a third and one situation.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
They'll look to make it 3 for 3 on third down conversions. They need a yard here. Oh, they go with a tight end carry. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
How about that there? No frills, no additives, right? Nothing crazy. Just find a way to pick up the first down. A nice run right there.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Up the middle, here's Stevenson. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Here's second and 10. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Now a short one to Gesicki. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it's 3rd and 4 now.
It's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing. Third and 4. On the draw is Stevenson. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. It's a pickup of 6.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
Jones now on 1st and 10. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
2nd and 10. To throw again. Jones. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
But it looked like he marched to the end zone. He's hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
Throw on 3rd down. Jones. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight on just about every throw. Forced a few here so far in this game, and now it brings up 4th down.
The offense stays put. They failed twice already in this first half, but they're going to go a 3rd time here on 4th down. To throw again. Oh, everything falling apart now. Another one intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And the Dolphins are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line. So that changes things. You get the interception, and then to boot, a good return tacked on.
And really, it was down to him versus the quarterback on the return, and that's one you would think the defender would win. but a nice job there of seeing the play all the way to the end and making the tackle by the QB.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. It has been about as perfect of a start to this game as these guys could have asked for, Charles. They've scored on their first two drives. They still haven't given anything up on the other side of the ball. So they can already make this a three-score game here if they can come away with points on this drive.
Yeah, they're almost pushing them to the brink, aren't they, partner? Almost to the point now where it's lots of words for me, which I know would excite them.
They've done has been working so far. Offense, defense, you name it, it's going well for them.
So now after the sack, Tua and the Dolphins staring at a third and long. What? Going to the air, Tagovailoa. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Juwan Bentley. And he's given his guys a shot for late points as they will take over in range for a field goal or maybe more. Here's a running play for Juju. It'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark it down at the 9. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
And while we're seeing more and more of these plays come from the college game into the NFL, and that one, it was run with great success, how about the evolution of the offensive linemen? We're seeing less and less big guys who can't move and more guys who are a lot more mobile and can get out in front of that type of a play.
This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Back to throw. Jones. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, congratulations to them. They come through defensively with another stop. And let's face it, this secondary, they've gone unchallenged so far in the first half.
Another shot from the 9 on second and goal. That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. Can't afford another delay here as they come up again on second and goal. The final shot before break. Jones. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Patriots nothing. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. The Dolphins in front, and they'll be in possession of the football first as the second half gets started. A very interesting call, and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get
blitz coming, and down he goes. Buried by multiple defenders on the drive's first play. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Now a give to Mostert running right. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That good for 19 on a first down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On first down, Tagovailoa. Open man is here. He's got it. And he's brought down, but not before a gain of 13, down to the 13. First and 10 in the run zone.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try to put the hammer down and finish this one off.
On first and 10, it's Mostert. Powering his way forward. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Raheem Mostert, a 13-yard touchdown run. And the Dolphins have moved out in front by three touchdowns.
And that's a drive that makes everyone happy on that bench, because they accomplished exactly what they set out to do. Take care of the football, eat up a little clock, end up in the end zone. Now they've got a cushion for the rest of the game. So they didn't just help themselves offensively, they helped their defense out as well.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And it's now 21 to nothing. Kick it away after the touchdown. And no return from Montgomery. Bring it out to the 25. The Pats at the line, ready to go.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Third quarter from Miami. This is second and 10. Out of the gun, they give it to Stevenson. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Jones to throw on third down. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. An excellent pickup of 34 yards.
Now look, you're not going to be able to get this all back at once, but that certainly helps.
So you're saying 3 yards in a cloud of dust, not the strategy?
I go aerial attack.
Yeah, I think that's what has to happen. And if you're going to run it, you need to break off big chunks. We just saw a big play right there. They need plenty of those.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Brandon Byron Jones picking it off. And the Dolphins will take over here at their own 14-yard line.
Boy, Charles, that is now three interceptions in three consecutive drives, and you can see he's just got a look of disgust and bad body language, understandably, as he walks off the field.
And I think it comes from the fact that he's not sure what he sees down the field, Brandon. I don't know if he's seeing ghosts. I don't know if he just can't read defenses. I'm not sure what it is, but that's why he's frustrated. Think about the defense right now. Every time they run on the field, they've gone from hoping to intercept a pass to expecting to intercept passes. Their confidence at an all-time high right now.
They go back to the ground, this time Mostert. And from the 15, they're able to work this up to the 20 for a pickup of a handful.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry, and they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
Tua gonna throw. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is gonna have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Achane on the counter. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk at a 45. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Dolphin first down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo.
Hey, come on, two.
Setting to throw on first down is Tua. And going deep for Hill. And this is caught. Touchdown. Tyreek Hill. 55 yards. And the Dolphins will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third. He's tough to contain as it is, but in man coverage with a pretty deep pass downfield, really tough to contain.
And it's so difficult because every play, you've got to consider he might try and run past you. So your goal as a defensive back is to give him plenty of cushion, meaning lots of space between you and him. If he wants to catch the short stuff, come up and secure the tackle, hit him a bunch during the game, and try and keep him in front. If you turn your head for a second, if your concentration wanes,
bye-bye.
He just takes off and goes, and I think that's what we just saw there.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And no return from Montgomery. Bring it out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
With a first down as they begin the drive. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Throwing again, Jones. Going deep here for Parker. And oh my goodness, here's a fifth interception. Picked up by Javon Holland. And the Dolphins are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line. Well, there's two sides to this coin. I mean, on one side, five interceptions now thrown for him. That's tough. But, man, this defense, they have been ball-hawking and impressive. But, Charles, let's flip it back over. If you're coaching a quarterback that's struggling this much at this stage of the game, do you maybe try to get him out?
I would think about it, and I think about it awfully hard, but also you might want to look into his eyes, see what he has. He might be one of those players that you don't want to affect his confidence by actually pulling him out of the game. So you have to know your player. You have to know the situation.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. From just shy of midfield, here's a second and eight.
All right, fellas, listen up. Solo left. Turbo one, high.
Tua sets up to pass it. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
And the punter Bailey on now as he sends this one away. The Pats at the line, ready to go. Well, it's been a struggle so far for this offense, Charles. It's not only that they haven't been able to put the points up, but really stringing yards together has been a real issue for them in this one.
I'm so glad you brought up the yardage, because I was thinking to myself, we've seen a lot of NFL games, and we've seen our share of lopsided contests, but in almost all of them, both offenses have put up at least 200 yards in a game, but not in this one. This has been a display of offense that, frankly, I think the two of us have watched from behind our hands, trying to spread our fingers wide enough to actually see the result.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Off play action, Jones. And that's too tall for his receiver. It's incomplete.
And that's another play that's painting the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
This offense on third down today, they've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This is third and 10. Looking to throw, Jones. Able to find the open man, that's complete. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And with this game well in hand, perhaps we are seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for a first down.
Well, we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline, because he certainly wants him to finish this one out the way they started it. He doesn't want to give up any soft completions, no late points. He wants his lead to stay right where it is.
Back to throw again.
Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
On second and 10, Jones going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. He's going to let it go again. And my goodness, another interception. Picked out by Jalen Ramsey. And the Dolphins will take over here at their own 14-yard line. What a nightmarish game he's having now. Six interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it. But it just tells you about the game of football. It giveth and it taketh away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown six interceptions in a game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it three times. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. They'll try and lay this out for Chosen. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
I think it's fairly safe to call this game over, but they're still trying to bomb it downfield and add to their lead. Almost makes you start to feel for the defense and root for them a little bit, too.
Ready. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. In motion left, Hill. And they'll get it forward to him on the touch pass. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Boy, an effective play there, getting their wideouts involved in the run game.
And they're always hoping on that type of a play that they can get to the end of the line and have a chance to turn it upfield as he did there. That means they controlled the blocking and took care of the defensive end or the outside linebacker to give him that lane.
And I guess I need to clarify, I said getting their wideouts involved in the run game, but of course that was actually a pass as he popped it forward.
Rush coming and he's taken down. And now they're in the hurry up.
It's a loss of 8, brings up 2nd and 18 at the 25-yard line.
Father, load.
Here's Tagovailoa to throw. And going deep for Hill. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes, you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one. Weren't able to do so.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need...
They'll let this go deep for Waddle.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Adrian Phillips.
And the Pats are going to take over here at their own 22-yard line.
Their own 22-yard line.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive.
Well, I hate to say it, but at this point, I don't really know that they're playing to win with this deficit in the fourth quarter. They're just trying to erase that zero on the scoreboard, Charles, and gets...
And now here is another interception. Dropped by Jalen Ramsey. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. They'll run right side with Mostert to the 27-yard line.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
That one looks like he'll throw here. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
On third down, here comes Mostert. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. 78 yards now on the ground at just 7 carries.
Hate to be blunt, but it is just continuing to prove to be the case that this O-line is manhandling this D-line right now.
They deserve to roll up their sleeves and show up their biceps because they're doing exactly what you just did.
And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. Sanders on for the extra point.
Now, this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown.
And no return from Montgomery. Bring it out to the 25. At their own 25-yard line.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. At this point, partner, things looking pretty bleak. They still haven't scored here in the fourth quarter, facing the big deficit. What silver linings, what can they look to do here offensively?
You know, it's funny, I talked about this with a coach in the offseason and kind of had this scenario, like, what feels good to you and what feels good to your team? You're down big. You really have, like, one possession left, and you're trying to put points on the board that don't matter. But do that? And he told me they actually do matter. And in this situation, he's going to try and run the best offense he can run to have at least a little bit of confidence to take away from that game. So right now, they're going to try their best to get something up on the board and not get shut out.
That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
Nice game there, partner. But you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score. They're not going to win this one. Right now, they're playing for pride and fantasy points.
And just to erase that goose egg, nobody wants to be shut out. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Douglas.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
From the 38, Jones. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey, and a big return will get him all the way down to the 35.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at the 35-yard line.
From the one.
On the handoff, this is Mostert. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. And quickly, they get to the line. On second down, Tua. That's going to be caught. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. 23 yards on the play.
But I have to tell you, just one word keeps coming to mind from watching them this afternoon, and that's impressive. They have been impressive from the opening kickoff, and they haven't let up here even in.
And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Sanders now to add the extra point. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Looks like they're going to keep throwing till the bitter end. This one's long since over, but give them credit. They're going to go down fighting. That one, incomplete.
To throw on second and 10. Jones. He's got a man complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. So a victory here for the Miami Dolphins. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets.